good Lord, spare thy people whom thou hast redeemed with thy most precious blood, and by thy mercy preserve us forever.
Save us, good Lord,
from all evil and wickedness, from sin, from the crafts and assaults of the devil, and from everlasting damnation.
Good Lord, deliver us
from all blindness of heart, from pride and glory and hypocrisy, from envy, hatred, malice, and from all wrongs of charity.
Good Lord, deliver us
from all inordinate and sinful affections, and from all deceits of the world, the flesh, and the devil.
Good Lord, deliver us
from all false doctrine, heresy, and schism, from hardness of heart and contempt of thy word and commandments.
Good Lord, deliver us
from lightning and tempest, from earthquake, fire and flood, from plague, pestilence and famine.
Good Lord, deliver us
from all oppression, conspiracy and rebellion, from violence, battle, and
unprepared. Good Lord, deliver us
from the mystery of thy holy incarnation, by thy holy nativity and submission to the law, by thy baptism, fasting, and temptation.
Good Lord, deliver us
from thy agony and bloody sweat, by thy cross and passion, by thy precious death and burial, by thy glorious resurrection and ascension, and by the coming of the Holy Ghost.
Good Lord, deliver us.
In all time of our tribulation, in all time of our prosperity, in the hour of death, and in the day of judgment.
Good Lord, deliver us.
These sinners do beseech thee to hear us, O Lord God, and that it may please thee to rule and govern thy holy church, universal in the right way.
We beseech thee to hear us, good Lord.
That it may please thee to illumine all bishops, priests, and deacons with true knowledge and understanding of thy word, and that both by their preaching and living they may set it forth and show it accordingly.
Speak to hear us, good Lord.
That it may please thee to show thy pity upon all prisoners and captives,
earth, so that in due time all may enjoy them.
We beseech thee to hear us, O Lord,
and it may please thee to inspire us in our several callings to do the work which thou givest us to do with singleness of heart, as thy servants and for the common good.
We beseech thee to hear us, O Lord,
and it may please thee to preserve all who are in danger by reason of their labor or their travel.
We beseech thee to hear us, O Lord,
and it may please thee to preserve the life of all women in childbirth, young children and orphans, the widowed and all whose homes are broken or torn by strife.
We beseech thee to hear us, O Lord,
that it may please thee to visit the lonely, to strengthen all who after in mind, body, and spirit, and to comfort with thy presence those who are failing and infirm.
We beseech thee to hear us, O Lord,
that it may please thee to support, help, and comfort all who are in danger, necessity, and tribulation.
We beseech thee to hear us, good Lord,
that it may please thee to have mercy upon all mankind.
We beseech thee to hear us, good Lord,
that it may please thee to give us true repentance, to forgive us all our sins, negligences, and ignorances, and to endure us with the grace of thy Holy Spirit, to amend our lives according to thy holy word.
We beseech thee to hear us, good Lord,
that it may please thee to forgive our enemies, persecutors, and slanderers, and to turn their hearts.
We beseech thee to hear us, good Lord,
that it may please thee to strengthen such as who stand, to comfort and help the weak-hearted, to raise up those who fall, and finally to beat down Satan under our feet.
We beseech thee to hear us, good Lord,
that it may please thee to grant to all the faithful departed eternal life and peace.
We beseech thee to hear us, good Lord,
that it may please thee to grant that in the fellowship of the ever blessed Virgin Mary, blessed Joseph, blessed Peter, blessed Paul, blessed Timothy, and all our saints, we may attain to thy heavenly kingdom.
We beseech thee to hear us, good Lord.
Son of God, we beseech thee to hear us.
Son of God, we beseech thee to hear us.
O Lamb of God, that takest away the sins of the world,
have mercy upon us.
O Lamb of God, that takest away the sins of the world, be with you.
And with thy spirit.
Let us pray.
The Lord be with you.
And with thy spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to St. Luke.
Glory to thee, O Lord.
And after his baptism, Jesus, full of the Holy Spirit, returned from the Jordan and was led by the Spirit for 40 days in the wilderness, tempted by the devil. And he ate nothing in those days. And when they were ended, he was hungry. The devil said to him, "If you are the Son of God, command this stone to become bread." And Jesus answered him, "It is written, man shall not live by bread alone." And the devil took him up and showed him all the kingdoms of the world in a moment of time, and said to him, "To you I will give all this authority and their glory, for it has been delivered to me, and I give it to whom I will. If you then will worship me, it shall all be yours." And Jesus answered him, "It is written, you shall worship the Lord your God, and him only shall you serve." And he took him to Jerusalem and set him on the pinnacle of the temple, and said to him, "If you are the Son of God, throw yourself down from here, for it is written, he will give his angels charge of you to guard you, and on their hands they will bear you up, lest you strike your foot against a stone." And Jesus answered him, "It is said, you shall not tempt the Lord your God." And when the devil had ended every temptation, he departed from him until an opportune time. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise be to thee, O Christ.
Jesus was led by the Spirit for 40 days in the wilderness, tempted by the devil. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Ghost. Amen.
Amen.
Good morning, everyone.
Good morning.
Can you imagine fasting for 40 days and 40 nights? That is quite the task. When I was at the Shota House, my first year, I only did this once. It was my first year. I really wanted to make my first Holy Week there special. So I decided to try out how strong my piety was, and I fasted the whole week. Holy Week. It was something. It was. At first I hated it, every minute of it. And I also learned that fasting breath is a real thing. I didn't know that you had bad breath when you fasted. You do. It's a stale, horrible taste in your mouth. I did not like it. And I couldn't chew gum because that was not a part of the fast. I couldn't suck on mints. No, I just had to deal with it. But one thing that I learned, though, by fasting is that it made me a different person. And I can't explain it completely. You'd have to do it yourself to find out. But it is, I suddenly realized that there was suffering in the world. Of course, I knew that, but I didn't actually feel it until I fasted. I felt people suffering. I started listening a little bit more naturally to the Holy Spirit, and I was able to kind of put myself on a different plane, a different plane of spirituality. And I was able to be more sensitive to the world around me. I was able to hear things I wasn't able to hear before. It was quite amazing, actually. And I would do it again. And then it dawned on me, does it really take an act of fasting in order to become holier? No, not necessarily, but it certainly helps. If you have the stomach for it, no pun intended, it helps. You know, I suddenly became more charitable, and my heart became a little softer, and I thought it was a wonderful experience. Jesus was having to fast in order to clear his mind. He was able to do that so he could clear his mind of nothing but God and holiness. And in the process, it helped him to see more clearly the needs of the world around him. As a result, he had a fruitful ministry. Why do you think he fasted? He had to. When we fast, we become more spiritually in tune. It helps to make us more spiritually sensitive to that, so that we can hear better what the Holy Spirit has to say to us. And I didn't know that until I did it myself. They don't really teach you these things. I had to find out by doing it. And it would be safe to say that a person, when they fast, can become more Christ-like because of this very thing that I'm talking to you about. You become more Christ-like when you fast because you start to see things differently and hear things differently, and you become more spiritually sensitive. And the Holy Spirit you hear the Holy Spirit more. And that is what I mean. As Christ fasted in the wilderness, we become more Christ-like in our fasts. It's quite amazing. Now, the devil will try to throw us off of our fasts whenever we're doing so. He will tempt us. He tempted Jesus. He showed up in the wilderness and tempted him with all kinds of things. Food, power. And each time, Jesus quoted scripture and sent him away. That is a Christ model that we all are supposed to be imitating whenever we fast. Anytime we feel tempted, anytime we feel like giving in and saying, oh, I'm just gonna start thinking and quoting scripture. Pick up scripture, start reading the Bible, and you'll find what you need. And that is what we are supposed to be doing. Because he will try with us. Being Christ-like is not what the enemy wants from us. So he will try to throw us off. He doesn't need more Jesuses in the world. He doesn't need that. He needs people who love him and love to follow the world. Because the world is comfortable and the world is fun. And the world makes us feel good. And it will kill us. Ultimately, it will kill us. It's important to always keep in mind that there's no escape from temptation, though. I hate to tell you, but there's not. I recall my senior sermon at Neshota House Seminary where I spoke on these things. It's a common misconception that being out in the middle of nowhere, away from so many things, will protect us from temptation and sin. But unfortunately, that is untrue. And Neshota House is no exception. It's a small seminary in a small village in rural Wisconsin. It's easy to have a false sense of security there. I reminded the students that Neshota House is not untouched. It's not this uncorrupt bubble, as much as we would all like to think, as much as they would all like to think. Temptation was all around us there. We struggled all the time in this category. We struggled at times with bitterness toward each other and with getting along. We fought. Oh, did we have fights? Sometimes the spouses got involved. Whatever struggles and weaknesses we had before we moved to the Neshota House, the temptation to fall back into those things oftentimes grew stronger. We were in seminary learning how to be shepherds. The devil was trying to throw us off track as much as he could. But when you're on the path toward righteousness, when we're on the path toward righteousness, the enemy is all over that. And he will try to knock us off our paths. There's no place on earth immune to the enemy. Jesus removed himself from society. He went out into the wilderness to get away and concentrate, and he was visited and tempted. In Life of Anthony by Athanasius, Anthony was attacked in the desert by the enemy, a very violent demonic attack. You can run, but you can't hide. We will be tempted during our Lenten disciplines. But if we look back and remember the rest of the story, what took place after those 40 days were over, this may give us a different outlook on things. If we remember what Jesus went through, his temptation, his torture, and his death, we'll be reminded that he also won the battle after all those things. The enemy was defeated. And if we read the end of the book, we'll see that the Lamb wins the ultimate victory. There is no scenario where the enemy comes out ahead. All he can do is tempt, discourage, and tear apart, and it can ruin our lives if we allow it to do so. Or we can put our faith in the Lord Jesus Christ, and through him we lean on our Heavenly Father for help and comfort. And we will prevail. We can do all things through Christ who strengthens us. In our epistle reading today, St. Paul's letter to the church in Rome, he says, if we call upon the name of the Lord, we will be saved. That has a double meaning to it. It's not just talking about our eternal salvation. It's talking about how Jesus coming to our aid when we need him. Yeah. Funny how God speaks to us through Scripture, sending multiple messages using just a few words. God is powerful. So when we feel tempted, all we have to do is immediately call upon the Lord and he will come to our aid. He is our help and our comfort. Deliver us, Lord Jesus, we pray, that we will have a blessed and fruitful Lent, becoming more Christ-like while coming to know you more. Amen.
Thank you. charity with your neighbors and intend to lead a new life, following the commandments of God and walking from henceforth in His holy ways. Draw near with faith and take this holy sacrament to your comfort and make your humble confession to Almighty God devoutly.
Good morning.
Good morning.
Just a few quick announcements. First of all, we had a really good beginning of our Lenten series this past week. It was so wonderful. Please come on the 11th, this next Friday, because Bishop Reed is going to be here to give the talk. So that's going to be fun. Of course, we will start dinner at 5:30. Also, ladies, if you have any kind of hobbies, if you are crafty or anything that you do when you are not busy, please bring it to St. Timothy's one Saturday a month. We haven't made a specific Saturday a month yet, but we are going to have a crafty day on the 19th. A few of the ladies are going to show up that Saturday around 11 to do crafting, planning. If you have a planner and you like to have planner stickers and working on planners or whatever you like to do, it's a good time for fellowship. There's please bring lunch because it is BYOL, BYOF. So definitely bring snacks, bring lunch, and just enjoy some fellowship. It's going to be great. Lastly, youth brags. Please don't forget about the youth rags. Send them in if there are any at all. Do we have any anniversaries or birthdays we'd like to celebrate this morning? Okay.
The Lord be with you.
And with our spirit.
Let us pray.
That we did not hear.
gave to them, saying, drink ye all this, for this is my blood of the New Testament, which is shed for you and for many for the remission of sins. Do this as often as ye shall drink it, in remembrance of me.
Lord, I am not worthy that thou shouldst come under my roof.
But speak the word of God, and my soul shall be healed.
Thank you. Thank you.
and of his Son, Jesus Christ our Lord, and the blessing of God Almighty, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Ghost be among you and remain with you always.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with my spirit.
In the beginning of the Holy Gospel according to John.
Glory to you, O Lord.
In the beginning was the Word, and the Word was with God, and the Word was God. The same was in the beginning with God. All things were made by him, and without him was not anything made that was made. In him was life, and the life was the light of men. And the light shined in the darkness, and the darkness comprehended it not. There was a man sent from God whose name was John. The same came for a witness to bear witness of the light, that all men through him might believe. He was not about the light, but was sent to bear witness of that light. That was the true light, which light of every man that cometh into the world. He was in the world, and the world was made by him, and the world knew him not. He came unto his own, and his own received him not. But as many as received him, to them gave he power to become the sons of God, even to them that believe on his name, which were born not of blood, nor of the will of the flesh, nor of the will of man, but of God. And the Word was made flesh,
and dwelt among us.
And we beheld his glory, the glory is of the only begotten of the Father, full of grace and truth.
Thanks be to God.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners now and in the hour of our death. Amen.
incarnation of thy Son, Jesus Christ, by the